The state government's showing every sign an election will be sooner rather than later. It's stepping up the sales campaign and a tax on labour.
The health minister going bed to bed if he has to improve our hospitals and let everyone know what a great job the government's doing.
If we look at some of the figures, they really are quite impressive.
A record 1.1 million patients were treated in Queensland hospitals this past year. The government says 122,585 more than in Labor's last year in power, for which the government takes full credit and full page ads.
People need to know how it is performing so they can make their own judgments.
Money unions say is better spent on doctors and nurses.
They'll leave no dollar not spent of taxpayers' money in convincing Queenslanders to vote for them next year.
Overnight, another branch revolt saved another threatened MP, Ros Bates, re-endorsed despite LNP bosses' doubts.
I'm displeased that tonight has shown the result that we have.
That's why there's talk of a rift in LNP leadership. This is the second MP to stare down the state executive. It's why Labor says there's a big gap between the top of the LNP totem pole and the grassroots.
Tearing itself apart, there's complete disunity and complete disloyalty.
Lawrence Springborg says Labor should worry about its own leadership.
But I think what you've got is the puppet and the puppet master, and the puppet is the leader of the Labor Party, and the puppet master is Joanne Miller.
Lawrence Springborg, he's counting down the days to the election and he's counting the numbers.
Shane Doherty, Nine News.